and his wife today. They are from the Indian High Commission. So I'm going to invite Pumal Somat on stage. And
thank you. First of all, I'd like to thank Gogo, who firstly introduced me to this community. And again, Reverend David, they have been in contact with my wife also. So he said, this is Reverend David, and then this is Montu Dr. Laldena, who was a professor, famous professor among us in Malibu. And I think a few years back, they kept in touch, and they knew each other. Because Professor Laldena used to come to London for his research. A lot of research. He's a writer. He's mad with writing. It's very old now, but he keeps writing. He's one of the well-known personalities in our community, in our area, in Manipur itself. So this morning I thought, I was thinking that we may not be able to come, and then Gogo told me that you have to be the good pa. I said, I have never been a good pa in my life. I don't want to be a good pa now, because I'm not old enough to be a good pa. Good pa normally should be at least like above 60 or 70. Pa means father. So at this young age, I'm not young at all now. Mentally I'm young, but physically I may not look young. But he told me that no, you have to be a good pa. He said, no, let's wait for some time. Not this year, I'm still very new to be a good pa. And then there may be many other elders who could be fit for a good pa. I could not predict anything about our office work. Maybe we may be called anytime. So this time I escaped, and sorry for all these things that I have turned down your offer to be a good pa. So it's a very rare thing to be a good pa, but I'm sorry for not accepting that one. So there are many other reasons which I cannot say here. And secondly, I'm very thankful to be invited with my wife. They used to call better half, but I always say better 100%. People say half, I don't say half, I say 100. So with my 100 better, we'll come this evening. And then she says she's always very punctual. And then she says it's 5 o'clock. And then you have to reach there. I said, no, I'm driving, and then I can't drive in London, and people are very strict, and then they have so many rules and regulations. I can't drive as well. They said, so they said we can reach around 6 also. But by the time we came to us, almost 6, then I drive slow. And so we came down then. So I'm so thankful that you have been waiting for me, not starting the program, and so that we can meet in full right now. So let me just, in one proverb they used to say that those who make a short lecture or short preaching are always old again. So I want to follow that. In our country in India, there are things which we compare with, like a Hindi movie used to be about 2 hours. So when somebody is having a long speech, we used to call, oh, this is a Hindi movie. When somebody is having a very short, crispy speech, then we used to call, oh, this is English movie. So because the English movie is shorter, then the Hindi movies are more than 2 hours. So that is how we used to compare the speech. Okay, let me not make it lengthy. So we reached here on March 23 this year, and we have barely stayed for about 4 months so far. And I'm still very new to the UK, and as well as to London. And before I came here, we have to study the entire thing. How is UK, who all stayed there, how many Indians there, how many people from the Northeast are there. So they told me, and they used to say that, no, the moment you land up in the UK and London, it's a mixture of so many things that you never feel like it is an English county. I thought that once I end up in the UK and London, yo, I'll find so many white guys, white people with brown hair, they walk along the roadside, they'll speak good English. Like this, I was thinking, like this, I landed up in a fancy English movie. No, it was not like that, they said. So you'll find so many Asians, people like you, like your own brothers and sisters, you'll find there. And then there are many, many people from the African side, from the Middle East. It's a mixture of so many of the people. I said, how could they control so many races like that, different types of mentality? So no, they have a system, and then they are very nice. And once you land up there, you'll find that everybody is well equally treated, and then there is nobody like racism and this and that. Oh, I see. So this is the first time I heard that in a white county there is no racism, that everybody lives equally and properly. So I ran up there, I really found that, yeah, it's real, that the place is so nice, and then you walk along the roadside, wherever you go, you don't feel anything. I found that people are, you know, equally treated, you know, even in looking and going to the shop, and then when you approach people. So now I found that it's a very nice place and a well-civilized country, and it's a good place to live. And that's the reason why all of you have been staying here for the past 20 years and survived, and you know, have been doing very well. And I would like to thank also our Reverend Derek. Normally in a community, there would be always somebody, one or two persons, who would bear the entire problem of the community and the society. It is him. Because whenever there is a program to be organized, he may have to call people around and then like look after. So he's really a good pa for today. Now, with this short stint of my stay here, the past 4 months, I've gone to Mizo Kut also, 2 weeks there. And then there's another Kut here. So we people, those who are from the northeast part of India, when the English came there about 10 years back, they made a research on our identity. They put us in the group called Tibeto-Burman tribes. So probably you have been originating from the Tibet side. And I was in Kathmandu. I was in the Indian embassy in Kathmandu. Yes, I've been in contact with so many Hume tribes like the Gorkhas, the actual native inhabitants of Nepal, so who came down from the Tibet side. So I used to study the language. I have a look on the language, or root language and all that. So there are many similarities of language between our language, between this Gorkha language, dialect, or if you want to say dialect. Me, I said language, they have been very old. So I studied the root language. There are many similarities between the Gorkha, different types of Gorkha language and the language we are speaking now. Because they call Samsan, and they call Kut, they call Na, like this, Ja-ha, like this. So many similarities are there. So you call Fox Sihal, they also call Sihal. So there are many similarities in the language. So I think what the English writers and scholars have studied 200, 300 years back, which they left. We are actually the Tibeto-Burman tribe origin, which traveled from this side and coming down like this. Okay, that is the short background of our history, in case you may want to know. And here in UK, probably we have, there are different communities staying together here. As I enter here, I could see, this is my tribe particular plot, you know, this one. This is Thamsun for the same thing I have here. And you'll find it so many other plots. So it's very nice to see. When the flowers are together, it's always nice to see in the garden, different types of beautiful flowers. So India being a very big country, we have at least 2,500 dialects, different types of dialects. And India, such a democratic country, can accommodate the entire 2,500 languages. So it is not like you are enforcing one language and trying to substitute. It's not like that. The Indian democratic system, as it was given in the constitution as well, it's so accommodative, it is so inclusive, not exclusive. So inclusive that we have such a number of languages, but we all survive. So even my language, it's a Khmer language. It is recognized as major Indian language. It is written allowed to be written in the exam as well, like in Assam, in Manipur, and these two places. So how important is a democratic country? You can find the example in India, because we are all different types of tribes, so many colors, still, democratically, he can accommodate everything. That's what I want to convey this evening, also being one of the, we call it the Chin, Kuki, Mizo, Zomi tribes, all these communities. We speak different types of languages, but we all understand one another. That is the beauty of our democracy and our community. But I want to say a few things. And both of us with my wife, we have been in the External Affairs Ministry, the government of India. And we joined a long time back. We have been going together on foreign postings in an alternative, like two postings and then we come back again and do some training and then go out again. So we have been outside for a foreign posting 6 times. This is the 6th in the series. So we have been born, we have gone to the Maldives, we have gone to Tokyo, we have gone to Africa, just near South Africa, and then we went to Italy, Rome, and then after we went to Kathmandu, we went to Ethiopia. This is the 6th of our foreign posting. So quite good experience. However, there is something which the problem which we used to face in moving from one place to another is that I have completely lost my biological clock, what you call it. So now I don't know how I wake up and I don't know how I sleep, because there's a time difference here. So like eating heavy, eating, there are so many things to look into, and all these things are adjusted in our body, and then this biological clock factor is really very, very important. So we are like a very moving person from one place to another. And that was quite a nice experience to see all the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere, and how the sun rises, how late and how early, and all that. So it's quite good. And in all the countries I've been visiting, Tokyo, Japan used to be the most law-abiding country, I used to say. So after coming from Tokyo, from Japan, I found again that this UK is one of the most law-abiding countries. Because you see the traffic and all this thing. It's so strict and then it's so systematized that you feel like you obey the rule, you also obey the rule. So you only obey the rule and others are not obeying the rule. It's really painful. So when we all follow the rules, then it's quite easy. So it happens in Japan as well as in the UK. That's the bright side of these two countries I found. And I'm not just exaggerating or trying to flatter you. I mean that you are staying at one of the best countries. Please enjoy. Thank you very much for inviting me today with my wife. All the best.